गुड मॉर्निंग एवरी वन, माई सेल्फ जी नरसिम्लू, एसोसिएट प्रोफेसर, डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ ईसीई, सेंट पीटर्स इंजीनियरिंग कॉलेज हैदराबाद। टुडे वी हैव वीडियो लेक्चर ऑन एएम रिसीवर्स। व्हाट इज द प्रोसेस फॉलोड इन द रिसीवर? इट इंक्लूड्स थ्री मेजर सेक्शंस, हैविंग आरएफ एम्पलीफायर, डिटेक्टर, ऑडियो एम्पलीफिकेशन, स्पीकर, एंटीना। सिग्नल इज रिसीव्ड एट एंटीना इज वेरी लो बिकॉज इट ट्रेवल्स फॉर लॉन्गर डिस्टेंस। इट माइट बी ऑब्स्टेकल, इट माइट बी अटेंडेड, इट माइट बी डिटेक्ट। सो द सिग्नल रिसीव्ड एट एंटीना इज वेरी लो। इट नीड टू बी एम्पलीफाइड बाय यूजिंग लो नॉइस एम्पलीफायर एंड ट्यून्ड टू डिजायर्ड फ्रीक्वेंसी टू अवॉइड इंटरफेरेंस। Detector finds the information signal from the RF signal. Detector itself, it's like a demodulator. Further amplification is needed to give it to enough power to drive loudspeaker. Receiver parameters. Receiver parameters used to evaluate the ability of a receiver to successfully demodulate a radio signal, which are selectivity, sensitivity, bandwidth improvement factor, dynamic range, fidelity, insertion losses. Selectivity. It is ability of a receiver to accept a given band of frequency and reject all other frequencies, which is obtained using tuned circuits. Selectivity can be written in mathematically by using parameter Q, it is quality factor. Q is equal to XL by R. XL is the reactance of the inductor. R is the purely real resistance. The bandwidth curve from the tuned circuit is given by bandwidth is equal to FR divided by Q, where FR is the resonant frequency or center frequency. Q is quality factor of the circuit, which is define the bandwidth. Higher the Q means the narrower the bandwidth, but better the selectivity. So if you need more selective frequency, you have to be design the circuit, okay, with higher Q correspondingly, which is going to be having bandwidth is very narrower. Using the bandwidth of the receiver at minus 3 dB points not necessarily show rejection characteristics. Most common used 2 points, another at minus 60 decibels. Ratio of the 2 called shape factor, that is shape factor is equal bandwidth at minus 3 dB divided by bandwidth is 60 minus 60 decibels divided by bandwidth at minus 3 decibels. Example, high Q tuned circuits are used to keep the bandwidth narrow to ensure that only desired signal is passed. Assume that 10 micro Henry coil with resistance of 20 ohms is connected parallel with 101.4 picofarad variable capacitor. The circuit resonates at what frequency? And what is the inductive resistance? What is the selectivity of the circuit? What is the bandwidth of the tuned circuit? Find the upper and lower frequencies. You know, according to the question 1, what is the resonant frequency? It is equal to the 1 by 2 pi root LC. By substituting the value of L, value of C given in the question, you can determine FR is equal 5 MHz. What is the reactance of the inductor? It is equal to 2F, FR, L. We know what is the FR, what is the 2, what is the pi, and how to substitute here L, then we will get XL is equal to 314 ohms. Then Q is a quality factor, XL by R. Substitute XL and substitute R, then you will get this Q is equal 15.7 bandwidth FR divided by Q. Substitute respective values. You will get bandwidth is equal to 318.47 kilohertz. One off on each side of center frequency of 5 megahertz is equal to the 0.159 megahertz. Upper frequency 5 plus 0.159 is equal to 5.159 megahertz. Lower frequency is FN 5 minus 0.159. It is equal to 4.841 megahertz. The sensitivity, its most important parameter in receiver. The minimum RF signal that can be detected at the input of a receiver, and the receiver still is able to produce demodulated information signal, then you can say the sensitivity of the receiver is very high. Here the sensitivity is also called as receiver threshold. Here depends on the noise power present at the input of the receiver noise figure, sensitivity of the AM detector and the bandwidth improvement factor of the receiver. The best way to improve the sensitivity is by reducing the noise level. Reduce the temperature, reduce the bandwidth of the receiver, or improving the receiving noise figure. Bandwidth improvement factor. One way of the reducing the noise level is by reducing the bandwidth of the signal. There is no limitation for reducing the bandwidth to make sure information is not lost, as RF bandwidth at the input of the receiver is higher than the IF bandwidth at the output of the receiver. Reducing the RF bandwidth to IF bandwidth ratio effectively reducing the noise figure of the receiver, thus reducing the noise. Where you have to understand IF is the intermittent frequency. The bandwidth improvement expressed mathematically, like you know, BI is equal BRF divided by BIF. BRF means bandwidth of the radio amplifier. BIF is nothing but bandwidth of the intermediate amplifier. Noise figure improvement expressed as 10 log base 10, 10 log base 2 BI. Dynamic range. The minimum input level necessary to design a signal and the input what will overdrive the receiver and produce distortion. Minimum receive level is a function of the front end noise figure and the desired signal quality. Input that produce distortion is function of the net gain of the receiver. 1 decibel compression point is used for the upper limit for usefulness. The fidelity means faithful reproduction of the transmitted signal at receiver. A measure of the ability of the receiver to produce at the output of the receiver an exact replica of the original source information. Any amplitude, frequency, phase, variations present in demodulated waveform that are not included in the original signal are considered as distortion. Insertion losses. Loss occurs when signal enters the input of the receiver. Parameters associated with the frequencies that fall within the passband of the filter, defined as the ratio of the power transfer to the load with a filter in the circuit to the power transfer to the load without a filter. Tuned radio frequency receiver. This is the basic understanding how the receiver works. Tuned is going to be obtained by using the tank circuit. Once you observe here, it is having the capacitor and inductor. This is going to be acting like a tank circuit. It is variable resistor and variable capacitor. By varying this capacitor, you can be tuned to particular frequency. That frequency only going to be received by your receiver. Okay, other frequencies are going to be rejected. How best you are tuning to particular your frequency, then only you can receive that particular frequency. If tuner is not working properly, then it is going to be received, okay, along with your frequency, others frequencies also. So other frequencies will be acting like a noise to your desired signal frequency, which will become to your demodulator. It will disturb the reception of your actual desired signals. The tuned RF receiver. It is the earliest and simplest receiver design. TRF consists RF amplifier stages, detector and audio amplifier stages. The receiver signal is tuned by LC circuit to pass band centered at carrier frequency. The selectivity pass only the desired signals, others are rejected. The tuned signal is boosted up by any amplifier for better info detection. Signal info detection is made at the demodulator and further amplified for the speaker output. Here, this one is a best example how the circuit diagram is looking for the tuned radio frequency amplifiers. You see this one, here receiver antenna, antenna coupling network, RF amplifier, which are all tuned circuits and which are going to be amplify the particular frequency. Why these all tuned circuit bank is there? It means the bank of filters or bank of capacitors or bank of inductors, which will be from the bank of tank circuits, which are used to make it tune the frequency very fine. It might, by having the first stage, it might be not tuned to the particular frequency. That can be performed by second one. If it's not performed by second one, third one that can be performed. Like that, you can be going to be receive the fine tuned frequency. Furtherly, the tuned frequency signal is actual frequency signal which was given to you, transmitted information, which is going to be detected by using the audio detector and amplifier. Then it is connected to the speaker. TRF has high sensitivity, ability to drive the speaker to an acceptable level to amplify. Disadvantages of the TRF: bandwidth is inconsistent and varies with the center frequency when tuned over wide range of input frequencies. Selectivity changes means that the extent to which a receiver can differentiate between the desired signal and other signal. Instability due to the large number of RF amplifiers all tuned to the same center frequency. Oscillations may come. Gain is not uniform over wide range of frequencies, because as these many circuits are there, might having the center frequency is not possible to maintain by all the tuned circuits are connected to the RF amplifier. RF amplifiers also not to be amplified uniformly. These are the some drawbacks in TRF, that is tuned radio frequency receiver. These problems can be overcome by using superheat rotating receiver. Superheat was designed to overcome the problem in TRF. It is having complex circuit compared to TRF, but excellent performance under many conditions. Heterodyne mean to mix two frequencies together in a non-linear device, or to translate one frequency to another using non-linear device. What is superheterodyne? Receiver tunes to desired signal and convert the signal to intermediate frequency via signal mixing circuit. Then IF signal is optimized to fully recover the modulated information signal.